My name is Michael Nacken, and I'm the Chief Technology Officer at Chef Steps. At Chef Steps, we're using software, technology, hardware, video to help people be better cooks and to cook more. For our website, every single thing you can imagine is stored in a database. So every recipe is in a database, and there's nested tables for every ingredient, every piece of equipment, every step of a recipe, every video that's in a recipe. Without a database, our business really wouldn't exist. Many of the popular apps and websites you use share information like photos, status updates, or messages with others. But how can your friend access information that you've created on your device from their device? The answer is that the information isn't being stored on your phone, nor is it sent directly to your friend. Instead, the app uses a network of remote servers to permanently store and access shareable data. When you post an image to your account, it is uploaded over the internet to one of these servers. When your friend logs into their account, a web request is made. The server finds where the photo is stored and sends it to your friend's device. The server acts as a central hub, ensuring that the information is permanently stored and available for multiple users to access. Sometimes we call this network of servers the cloud, and it's at the core of most of the apps you use. Servers sort information using databases. A database is any organized collection of data. There are many ways to structure a database, but one of the most common is as a collection of tables made of rows and columns. When you post new information to your account, it will be added to the appropriate database table so that the server can quickly find it when it is requested later. Let's have a look at how we can create and use remote databases in AppLab. Let's make a very simple app that asks users their favorite food and saves the answer to a database. With this information, we can compare results from all the users. We've set up the first step, which grabs the user's favorite food and logs it to the console. In AppLab, you can save data to the app's remote database using the Create Record block under the Data category. We want the data to be saved when the user clicks the Submit button, so we'll place the block inside the OnEvent function. The Create Record command takes three parameters. The first parameter is the table name. This is where you will store a new row of data. When you give a table name, AppLab will try to find a table name matching the one you provided. If it does not find an existing matching table, it will make a new table with that name. Let's call our table Fave Foods. The second parameter of Create Record is the object you are storing in the database, called a record. In AppLab, a record is an object. A table is essentially a collection of objects stored in the cloud. In our example, we want the column name to be food, and the value in that column will be the string the user provided, which we stored in the variable response. The third parameter is the callback function. The onEvent callback function gets called when the user triggers the specific event you are watching for. The callback function of a database command, like create record, gets triggered when the remote database completes the action and sends a message back. In the case of create record, the database simply sends back a copy of the record that was stored as verification that it was done successfully. Let's try our simple app. We'll put in a few different foods: apples, pizza, and then apples again. So, what happened? Did the records successfully get created in the remote database? We do see the string record created in the console that confirms the database executed the command, but ideally we would see the table and all the records themselves. Fortunately, AppLab allows you to view the data your app has stored via the data viewer. We'll find out more about that in the next video.